Interested in getting started with DevNet? Stay tuned for this next episode as we talk to our newest dev advocate, Dewan Lightfoot, about all the opportunities to start now with Cisco and Cisco DevNet.
Hey, Snackers, this is Kareem Iskander. I'm a developer advocate with Cisco DevNet.
Hey, everybody, Matt DiNapoli. I'm a manager of developer advocacy with Cisco DevNet.
Welcome to episode 13 of DevNet Snack Minute. If you don't know what Snack Minute is by now, Snack Minute is your weekly 10-minute all things DevNet, giving you a quick, fun way to learn about Cisco APIs, coding, and just some cool stuff.
And the cool stuff we're going to be talking about today is DevNet Start Now, and we have a very special guest with us. Dewan, would you mind introducing yourself?
Hey, what's up, everyone? I'm Dewan Lightfoot. I am a Cisco developer advocate, brand new to the team. Excited to be a part and join you two and everyone else that are doing what we do to help the community grow in network automation.
Oh, it's great to have you with us. It's great to have you on the team. Everyone, if you don't know, Dewan is actually one of my developer advocates. And so it's been awesome to have him on our team, even in the first 2 weeks that he's been with us. And so he's going to be talking to us today about our Start Now content. So Dewan, can you kind of give us a layout of what Start Now is and what you're looking to do to help people get involved with DevNet and in the program?
Of course. Thanks, Matt. And thank you, Kareem, for having me on. So when we talk about DevNet, what does that mean? Well, it means one thing for certain, and that's Cisco network automation and everything around the APIs, the tool sets when it comes to Cisco network programmability. Well, another question with that is, where do you start with DevNet? Well, at developer.cisco/start now, we have a whole curated set of content to help you get started in network automation in reference to Cisco and the latest technologies, not just Cisco. Let's say you want to learn something about Ansible, or you want to learn about APIs and REST or Python, or you want to learn how to automate, let's say, ACI with Terraform. All of this content is curated right here on Start Now. And my goal is to bring that content together to the community, present it in a way that's digestible, understandable, and as a resource to help you not only get started in network automation, but to take your career to the next level, because we have SMEs in each one of these areas in the Start Now content that are putting out some great content. So I want to help provide all of that content to you, the community.
Dewan, welcome to the team. And I wanted to ask you, before you joined us, what was your background and how did DevNet help you?
Well, Kareem, I'm a veteran. I got started in IT as a veteran. And so in that time, I started doing help desk. I went on to do system administration and network engineering. My last role, I was a network automation infrastructure engineer. And in that role, I was responsible for supporting hospitals around the country. A key point from that role was not only my network automation work, but during that time, like, we're in a pandemic. So hospitals needed to extend their VPN networks to support those remote workers. When they talk about hospitals being overloaded, and the networks were a big key to that overload. So in my role, I had to make sure that they had the resources they need and they were available when they needed them.
That's very cool. And can you tell us about how DevNet helped you out with that?
Yes. So when it comes to DevNet, I think the coolest thing for me when I first started on my journey was not just the learning labs, but the sandboxes. So I had to, in my last role, I automated a lot. And so what I found very useful was the always on Apex. I used to write Postman scripts constantly Postman calls to query the Apex so I could structure my Python scripts and return the data that I'm looking for in my scripts and be able to parse through that information. And the always on sandboxes was a key point, a key tool that I utilized in my last position for sure.
That's cool. Now, to get you up to speed on using Postman and Python and all that stuff, did you find yourself kind of scrounging around for material within DevNet, or did you, you know, we kind of just started the Start Now, which we're going to talk about it, you know, in depth in a minute. Did we have Start Now in place when you started with it, or did you, you know, find different ways to get up to speed with using Postman, using Python, and building out those collections to make your calls to your Apex?
I think when I got started, you just had like the modules. So I was actually just going through the modules, learning, and actually wrote a blog post about the 30 modules you should learn like right now. And I went through a lot of them.
That's cool.
That's a lot of learning labs.
Yeah, it's a lot of learning labs.
All right, Dewan, this is great. Do you mind just walking us through what you have in Start Now and how do I get started with it?
Sure, no problem, Kareem. Now, if we go over to developer.cisco/startnow, you'll find a ton of content focused on helping you get started with network automation and network programmability. Whether you want to learn coding and APIs, you click on it and you'll see different learning labs where you can go through and learn. You can start with the basics of intro to APIs, intro to Python, intro to Git, and then you can expand on that to take it further in part two of learning Python and then introducing you to technologies like JSON. But this is just coding and APIs. We have the same level of great content for learning basic networking, enterprise networking, data center networking, Cisco Meraki. And the cool thing about this is these learning labs not only have content that's focused on teaching you, but it has labs that help you get started with network automation. So if you want to learn ACI, we have labs that will provide you with the Postman collections to help you query the always-on sandboxes, as well as sample Python scripts to help you get started with Python. It's awesome. And that's just two pieces, Terraform, Ansible, you name it. There's probably content here on developer.cisco Start Now. But I want to mention something. If there's content that's not there and you all want to see it, reach out to not only myself, but all of our DAs that are on social media. We're here to help you and we want to see you succeed.
Ben, you got me excited about going and visiting that site, even though I know about it and I've known about it for years. So
I'm kind of pumped about it too. Yeah. So Dewan, I know you're relatively new to the developer advocacy role, and it's, you know, you've taken it upon yourself to take a look at the Start Now content and see what we could improve. Do you have any ideas on how we could maybe approach Start Now for our larger audience to make it potentially even more useful and more accessible for our groups?
I think the best way to do that is for us to have those feedback loops, to communicate with the community, to see what their needs are. And then once we have an idea of what their needs are, we can tailor it towards that, because we have so much content there that is on developer.cisco that a lot of times the community may not know. So if you all have questions that or want to see a technology, if you want to learn and get started with a particular technology that may be in your organization or maybe new to Cisco, let us know.
And kind of a follow-up to that, who is this Start Now for? I know we just kind of say, hey, if you're just interested in getting started, but you know, if I'm sitting at home and I'm watching this video, I'm thinking, well, you know, I'm just a software application developer and you know, Cisco's not necessarily in my wheelhouse. Or I'm a network engineer and I'm pretty comfortable with that. Are there other, you know, personas that we could kind of take a look at to say, hey, you know, no matter where you live, you know, this might be interesting to you or this might be interesting to you?
I think we cover a wide range of technology domains. So if you are that application developer, maybe you are running WebEx in your environment. Have you all thought about integrating WebEx in some form of automation, a chatbot or something like that? There's a ton of different content and ways that you can utilize network automation from an application developer standpoint. But if you're that network engineer, there's even more tools for you to not only integrate WebEx within your network automation environment, but you can also integrate ACI and all of the latest telemetry tools that are here on developer.cisco. Start now.
All right, Dewan, we do this every episode whenever we have a guest on. And so we ask our guests, and I'm going to ask you this. If you had one superpower, what would that be?
If I had one superpower, it would be total recall. I would like to recall everything that I see, read, and hear. The way information is evolving at this rapid speed, it's hard to keep up. So if I had the ability to recall everything that I learned, life would be great.
That's awesome.
Yeah, that is a pervasive theme across a lot of our guests on Snack Minute. So really cool that that's your superpower too. That's all the time we have for this week, Snackers. Feel free to join us next week, and we'll see you guys later.
Peace.